In this tutorial, we are going to look at basics of strings in TensorFlow. We are going to make a string and we will perform some operations on our string. Operations such as to find the length of the string, to make it into lowercase, uppercase, to split the string. We will also run a for loop and we will make an array. We are going to do all these operations one by one in this video. Let's go and import TensorFlow STF. This is how you have to import TensorFlow. And once you have imported TensorFlow, let's make one variable and make one string and store in that variable. To make a string in TensorFlow, we use the function constant. Using constant function, we can make a string in TensorFlow. Now we have made a string in TensorFlow. Let's print our string. As we can see, the data type of this variable is string. This is how we have to make a string in TensorFlow. Now we are going to perform some operations on our string variable. First, we are going to find the length of our string. We can use the function length from strings. The length of the string is 12. Here we can see numpy is equal to 12 and the data type is integer, because 12 numbers, 12 is a number, so its data type is integer. We can calculate if there are 12 words or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are 12 words in our string, so it has calculated correctly. Now we can perform some other operations. We can make our string into lowercase. That is, we will make all the words into a lowercase. We can see here the D letter is, it is in the uppercase. The letter L is also in the uppercase. We are going to convert both this letter D and L into lowercase. There's a function called lower. We will use that function. tf.strings.lower. Now we can see it has converted our string variable into lowercase. All the values are now in the small letters, deep learning. Similarly, to convert our string into uppercase, there is a function called upper. We can use that function upper to make our string into uppercase, that is capital letter. Upper. We can see our string has been converted into uppercase. All the words are now in the capital letter. This is how we can convert into small letters, upper letter. These are the basic functions. We can also split a word and make two separate words. For example, we will type hello world and we will separate that hello world into two separate letters, and it will return us an array which will contain first hello and second it will contain world. Let's go and do that. Now we are going to pass the letter hello world. Here it is a one word, hello world. Now in the output we will see it has converted into array. Hello is one word and world is the second word, and the data type is object. This is how we can split our word in TensorFlow. Now if you want to decode your string into another format, for example UTF-8, you can use the function unicode underscore decode from strings to convert it into any Unicode. Tf dot strings dot Unicode underscore decode. This is a function which we are going to use now. We have to pass our variable string, and now we have to type the Unicode here. For example, UTF-8. You will get one number for each alphabet, and since we have 12 alphabets in our word deep learning, we get 12 numbers. We can see the number 68 represent the word D, 101 represent the word E, 101 represent the word E. Similar words are having similar number. These are all numbers for each and every alphabet. We can also iterate over list of tensors. We can run a for loop in strings. We will make an array and then iterate over the array. Let's make an array of strings. We are going to name that array list underscore array. To make an array, we will use the function constant, tf.constant. Now we are going to put some words like TensorFlow, Keras, PyTorch. Let's print our array. We can see this is a tensor and these are the words which we have stored in our array, TensorFlow, Keras, PyTorch, and the data type is a string. Now we are going to run a for loop and we will iterate over this list of array. Let's do that. For I in list underscore array, print I. We can see it has printed all the elements. First one is TensorFlow, the second is Keras, and the third is PyTorch. This is how you can run a for loop in your TensorFlow object. We can also convert a string into number. Suppose we have a number which is in the form of string, we can convert that into integer numpy. Let's do that. We have to use the function to underscore number from strings dot to underscore number. This is a function. Here we will pass some string, let's say 10.5. We can see the string has been converted into a number, numpy 10.5, and the data type is float because we are having number in terms of decimal. This is how a string can be converted into a number. This tutorial was about strings manipulation, how we can make a string in TensorFlow, what kind of operations we can perform on strings. There are many other operations which we can perform on strings. These are just a few of the basics one. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you for watching.